I'll start with a footnote. If a life worthy of the Bible has been lived within the last 100 years, it's that of Thomas, who started the peace vigil at the White House, quickly marginalized and ultimately killed in large part by the paranoid schizophrenic with paranoid dilute with persecution complex Concepcion. But before Thomas, just before Thomas ever hit DC and started the vigil, he went on a biblical leap of faith, a walk across northern Africa, a place immensely feared by Westerners, with not a cent in his pocket. I believe the scripture he cited was about the lilies of the field, but certainly about no care for tomorrow, no need for money, relying on the Creator for today. It's a must-read if you go to his blog, prop1.org, his website, prop1.org. Thomas is a link you should find on the main page. And on the page you then get, it should talk about life, liberty, and the hot pursuit. It's a must-read. It's a series of linked stories, essays, drawings, graphics. End of footnote. The potent Inshi warriors, insanely humane warriors of unviolence throughout history. These are the antithesis of reckless people. These are the antithesis of thoughtless people. And these are the antithesis of fundamentalist religious wackos who have rejected the truths of science, have rejected the truths of responsibly using our intellect and our senses. These are solidly grounded people. They may have strong mystical tendencies. They are absolutely people of the uncontrollable 80% of our nervous system that's the heart. But their feet are on the ground. So, the fact that they wind up in prison, the fact that their bodies are frequently at legal or physical risk or both, could easily be misconstrued as irresponsibility, recklessness. Suicidal tendencies, masochism. It's none of those. Several times last year, as I recall, within the last several years anyway, there have been two living recipients of the Medal of Honor. people that had repeatedly risked their lives in an incident to save comrades in arms. There's nothing that I see that suggests they were reckless, looking for martyrdom, casual with their own lives, without a tendency to think about tomorrow. But in the situation where so much was at stake, all tendencies that we consider normal in this sickest of all societies, to be prudent, to lay away for tomorrow, to avoid taking risks, to look out for number one, we're all squeezed to the sidelines. And I don't find those people crazy. I find them admirable and ones that I want to learn from and emulate. Some of you do too. So what's going on there? That in certain circumstances, it is pathological, it is not adaptive for the species. To be laying up for tomorrow, to be thinking about tomorrow. We have months to secure a future other than hell on earth for the next 2,000 generations, 200 billion people. This is the time to be putting money into our life insurance plans. This is time to be worrying if we're going to spend the rest of our lives in prison, if the best way to stop it is to put our bodies unviolently in the way of such a thing. This is the time to worry about whether we're going to die on death fast. If so, then those Medal of Honor recipients were fools. I'm in the middle of a video, friend.
Yeah, I need to water the plants. You don't mind?
Well, I don't. You guys have done it carefully before.
Okay.
These are fathers, mothers, and they didn't just decide they don't care about the people around them. They decided that being a human being, caring about all human beings, was part of what they owed to humanity, including their dependents. Driven by their sense of responsibility, not instead of it. I suspect this all sounds like duh, like really obvious, but if you're going to be fair, such thoughts are not those that stay prominent in our thinking as we meander through this sickest of all societies. We're distracted from such really obvious thoughts. If we're living as brother and sister to the 4 billion people on this planet, living on $4 a day, as brother and sister to the 26,000 children that will die tomorrow, that will die today, that will die day after tomorrow from lack of clean water, if we're living as brother and sister to the next 2,000 generations, we're laying up stores for tomorrow? Really? Oh no, I can't take that job. It's an internship. You're not going to pay me anything. I can't take that job. I'd have to live on the street on homeless food. Really? Really?